Hi, today we will be talking about web-based simulation tool for VHDL and Verilog HDL designs. The beauty of this tool is that you do not need to set up anything on your machine to use this for VHDL and Verilog HDL simulation. You just need an internet connection and your email ID. That's it. And you can start practicing your VHDL and Verilog HDL exercises in almost no time. So if you just started learning VHDL or Verilog HDL, this is the fastest way to start practice and simulate your VHDL or Verilog HDL designs. Yes, we are talking about EDA PlayGround. So these are the topics we would be covering today on EDA PlayGround simulation tool. We will start from how to open the tool, then we will do quick settings on the tool for VHDL coding, and we will select Video Simulation Tool for waveform analysis. Then we will write a simple VHDL design. Then we will write a test bench for our design, and finally we will simulate our design. So let's start. So first we will open EDA Playground. For this we will open Chrome and will type edaplayground.com in the URL of the web browser. Then you will see this page. This is our editor where we will write our VHDL code and test bench. Now the first step is to log in EDA Playground. So click on login from the top right. Now simply choose Gmail account for login. Enter your Gmail ID and password, or select your Gmail ID if already logged in. Now you are logged in to the tool. Now it's time for some basic settings. So you can see there are many options in the left panel. First, select the VHDL in test bench plus design. Because we are writing VHDL code, no worries about the library. So select none. Next is top entity, leave it blank for now, we will fill it later. Next is tools and simulator. So there are many options. In the top, there are commercial simulators which you cannot use with your Gmail ID. For that, you need to verify your account with your company or organization email ID. So we will choose from free simulator. We will select the first one, which is GHDL. Now tick this box for open EP wave after run. This is important to view waveforms for simulation. That's it. Now go to the VHDL editor and write your VHDL code. We are designing a simple AND gate for demo purpose. So type entity AND gate is port A colon in std underscore logic semicolon B colon in std underscore logic semicolon D out std underscore logic bracket close semicolon AND gate semicolon. Architecture behave of AND gate is begin D out gets a value of A and B semicolon AND behave semicolon. Very simple design, right? Now we will write the test bench for this. So this is test bench area. So write entity T underscore AND gate is AND T underscore AND gate semicolon. Architecture behave of T underscore AND gate is, now copy this AND gate entity and paste it in the test bench. Now replace entity with component. Now define signals. So write signal A comma B comma D out colon std underscore logic semicolon begin A1 colon AND gate port map A connected to A comma B connected to B D out connected to D out bracket close semicolon. Now type A gets a value of 0, then 1 after 10 nanosecond, then 0 after 20 nanosecond semicolon. Now signal B gets the value of 0, then 1 after 5 nanosecond, then 0 after 10 nanosecond, then 1 after 15 nanosecond, then 0 after 20 nanosecond. And behave. So line number 26 and 27 is important, which says A has value 0 initially, then it will be 1 after 10 nanosecond, and then 0 again after 20 nanosecond. Same for signal B, which is 0 initially, then 1 after 5 nanosecond, and then 0 after 10 nanosecond, and so on. And same we will see in simulation. Now before we run it, let's make some errors so that we can see how it handles error. So we are removing semicolon from the last of entity and then we will run it. Oops, we didn't give the top entity. So set the top entity as the underscore AND gate. Now run. So it gave the error, but you need to figure out that. You can change the top entity to AND gate, then you can see what is that error and you can correct it. Let's fix this for now by adding semicolon. Now run. So you can see the waveform simulation is visible. Let's remove the extra signals for A and B and D out so that we can see clean results. So move the marker at first instance. Here A is 0, B is also 0, so the output is 0. Next, slide it to second instance. Here is 0, but B is 1, so output is still 0. Now check the third instance. Here A is 1, but B is 0, so output is again 0. Now last instance. Here A is 1 and B is also 1, so our output is 1. So the behavior of our AND gate is okay in this design. I hope you feel confident now to start using EDA PlayGround for your VHDL and Verilog HDL exercises. If you found this video helpful, please give it a like and leave a comment below, and don't forget to subscribe for regular updates.